It's now my pleasure to introduce Nicola Bendington, who is the director of the European Patients Forum and who indeed is an important partner of the Innovative Medicines Initiative. Nicola will present us the patient's perspective.
Thank you very much, Michelle. I'm delighted to be here on behalf of the European Patients Forum. This is a really key opportunity to talk about meaningful patient involvement. In my brief presentation, I'd like to give you a little bit of an overview about the European Patients Forum and what we're about, what patients generally think of IMI so far, the rationale behind and the value, the added value of involving patients meaningfully, drawing on the outcomes of our own project called Value Plus, and a few reflections on moving forward on IMI with patients. So first of all, a little bit about our organization, the European Patients Forum. Our vision as an organization is high quality, patient-centered, equitable healthcare for all patients across the European Union. That's our starting point. And we aim to be a strong and united patient's voice in EU policy debates. We're an umbrella body of 45 European disease-specific organizations at European level, like Alzheimer Europe, but also national coalitions of patients, for instance, the Spanish Patients Forum, the Polish Patients Forum. And collectively, through our membership, we represent the interests of over 150 million patients with chronic diseases across the European Union. Why is IMI important for patients? Well, we just need to go back to the fundamental purpose of IMI, to reduce bottlenecks in pharmaceutical innovation, to address unmet medical needs of patients. This was something that was strongly highlighted in the Pharmaceutical Forum, in which EPF was also involved as the patient's voice. And the Pharmaceutical Forum called for real leadership in this area, which clearly IMI will provide. We like very much that there's an emphasis on core overarching issues of huge relevance for all patients: patient safety, knowledge management, education and training, risk-benefit analysis, but also real advances in very specific disease areas. Public-private partnerships, the value of public-private partnership was expounded very well this morning. We are very pleased to see a credible and vast public-private partnership between the European Commission on the one hand and EFPIA on the other hand, at a time where trust has never been so important. And of course, we're also very pleased to see the commitment within IMI to really consult and involve all stakeholders, including patients. So what's the story so far? Talking to some of my member organizations that are already involved in IMI projects, they used very crucially a single word, collaboration. I think they really recognize that they're being taken seriously as bona fide equal partners in the projects, albeit a few challenges. And I'll talk about that in a few minutes. But generally, we must acknowledge that there is a low percentage of involvement of patient organizations generally across the IMI. And I think we all recognize that actually more is possible. So how do we actually tackle this bottleneck, this specific bottleneck, in terms of awareness raising among project promoters, among consortia leaders, but also awareness raising among patient organizations themselves? I've explored again with some of my member organizations some of the real benefits of IMI. Patients as real partners was one quotation, and I go to the PROTECT project, which is a project aiming to strengthen the monitoring of the benefit risk of medicines in Europe. And among the 29 public and private partners is a patient organization called IAPO, our international sister organization, the International Alliance of Patient Organizations. And they mention their intrinsic role and the notion of collaboration and respect. They're involved in work packages looking at new methods of data collection from consumers, benefit risk integration and representation. What is their specific role? They're there to provide a patient's perspective, a unique patient perspective on all aspects of developing the work program, but also specifically responsible for developing a strategy for communicating with, recruiting, and retaining research subjects and providing them with appropriate information. Understanding how we as patients can best contribute. I talked to the patient organization involved in the UBioPred project, Unbiased Biomarkers in the Prediction of Chronic Respiratory Disease Outcome, our member organization, the European Federation of Allergies and Airways Diseases patient organizations, and they have a key role in this project, looking at the ethics work project work package, but also an involvement again in all of the work packages to inject a genuine patient's perspective. For them, what are the critical success factors in terms of being involved in this project? First of all, they were involved right at the onset, during the planning phase, the inception phase of the project, not at end of pipe. There's a real clarity within the project with regard to the role of patient organizations in understanding from the patient's own experience the impact on patients of severe asthma. The openness and receptiveness of the coordinator has also been very, very important. But also the use of language, the use of layperson's understandable language, so there's no alienation between the patient representatives and the scientists involved in the project per se. Disseminating outcomes to the layperson is another interesting arena where patients obviously play a role. And this is a feature of the PharmaCog project, prediction of cognitive properties of new drug candidates for neurodegenerative diseases in early clinical development. The patient organization involved there is Alzheimer Europe, another member of EPF, again providing the patient perspective, involvement in the design of appropriate informed consent forms, but also, crucially, responsible for dissemination of the outcomes to a wider interested public. There's a multitude of literature now on some of the benefits of patient involvement, and I think this is being increasingly recognized. There's also a recognition for the need for more policy attention and investment in patient involvement. And also the notion of research with rather than research on patients as an imperative, seeing that the purpose of all health research is ultimately to benefit patients.